bassist Tyler asked for a guitar tutorial on my song, I Quit Everything Today. So I'll show you how it's done. First off, capo on the fret 7. I think 7. This song is basically Angelina by Pine Grove, and then you start the first few seconds and you put it into a generative AI prompt and you're like, make this song keep going, and then it goes in a different direction than the original song, except for my brain did it instead of the computer. First shape is this, like, A sus 7. See the nice doubled. So yeah, let's see, starting, you just play, that's your thumb on the A string here, which is actually a D, since we're up, no, shit, it's an E, so it's, yeah, an E7 sus, but you're, it's the second fret for your pointer finger here, and the third fret, I'm sorry, on the D string. And then the third fret on the B string, and the third fret on the E string, high E string. And you use these four fingers for the top four strings, and then your thumb for the A string, and sort of roll the chord. And the same thing, except for the top, the E string goes down at the second fret. And I do that little pickup sometimes, going into the actual, downbeat, but you don't need to. That's just going on the open to the second fret on the A string. But it's so now you have those first couple chords going into it, and the next one is this C add 9, but it's actually we're not in E minor anymore, we're in B minor, so it's a G. Because I'm mimicking the melody of the book, Everything Today. So, oh my gosh, notifications. So, so third fret on the A string, second fret on the D string, open, third fret on the B string, open, and the thumb, it's kind of a Travis picking pattern, so the thumb goes, so for that first chord, it's just, between those two strings, and then your right hand, I use ring finger and index finger or middle finger. Ba ba ba. Sorry. Ba 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 ba. And a little sort of ghost note, not really ghost note, but just less emphasized note on that open string, on the open G string. Hard to play by itself. So you're taking this third fret B string guy up and down, and then so it's just walking down. I play it with my thumb. I know some guitarists love using the thumb. I'm one of them. Other guitarists are like, "What are you doing?" It's like my John Mayer thing, because he does that. I don't like a lot of what he does, except for he plays the blues well, and he uses his thumb. learning this, just doing the fingers before the thumb is probably useful. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, that's how it would fit into the measure, and then the thumb part with the 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. so those next chords are just a regular old G. And sometimes you strum all the rest of those on the second part with your thumb. We'll get to that though. So then, you know, it walks down. So just from the beginning. I forgot about that. Yeah, so when the thumb goes, your right hand is doing, which is a pull off from the G string, from going from second fret to open. I like to keep this finger on here because that note is nice with every chord. So in your left hand, I would be doing my index finger on that second fret. So you do the first, you do the F sharp, or, well, it wouldn't be an F sharp, it would be a C sharp going down to the B. And you do that, you do them together, actually, it's not first, you do it at the same time. And I like to do a little articulatory, like mordant or whatever, I don't know what the word would mean, a little. And recently, as I've started playing it, I hammer that on the downbeat, and then that comes on beat two of the, you know, three beats per measure. It's in three, it's a waltz. And I like rolling all those chords. Is it gonna? Never mind. What's the next steps here? We're trying to get down to. So, I guess I sometimes anticipate that, so it would be on the and of beat three of the measure before the actual. Sorry. The and of beat two. So 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1 and 2 and 3 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 1. And I'm realizing that this is swung, so it's actually kind of a triplet swing feel. And instead of that's another thing to keep in mind, is that you're playing on kind of this subdivision of each beat in the measure of three. You're playing mostly on 1 and 3 of that subdivision of each of the three beats in the measure, but that's probably easier to hear than to just play, or than to like think about and play. So we got to the G chord here, which is just, you know, third fret on the E string, second fret on the A string, open, open. And then I like this note, so third fret on the B string. And then keeping that, where we go. And that, I guess I take that finger off so I can do the articulation thing more easily. This is the weirdest part. This is the most confusing part. Dun, 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 dun. So it's this rhythm. I could explain it. I'll explain it theoretically, and then I'll just play it. It'd be easier if you just listen to it. You don't need to get it perfectly, but da 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 da. How do I actually play that? I'm trying to figure it out. It's some like syncopation of the three that is inside of each of the beats in the three beat measures. so that's what it is. So this is beat one of the E chord, or the E minor chord. This is actually a B minor chord with the capo, but it's an E minor shape, E minor 7 shape. So, second fret on the A string, and everything else is open. And your fingers are, these three are positioned on those, and your thumb is doing the bottom two strings, because it's like Travis picking, whatever. So the first two beats are 1 and 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3 1 2 3. So on 1 you do that, and then 3 you do that, and then on 1 and 3 of the next, of the second beat in the measure. So it's pointer finger for this, and then index finger for this, or sorry, middle finger for this, but you're separating them. Back to that E, except for the next one comes a little bit earlier, which is this finger, because it makes sense. I don't know why I did that. And that part is just chords that you play at the same time, and the chords are, so thumb again, it's the same thing from the walk, but we're going up this time, and it's, you're skipping the A string, it's just second fret on the E string, open D string, second fret on the G string, and the melodies, so that's the one that I try to emphasize along with all these other notes in the chord, and it helps that it's the top note. So yeah, chord one, and then chord two is just like a G chord, so third fret on the bottom string, the rest of these three open, or you can just do those two. You probably want to have the fifth though, because that's nice. Adding that note's nice. I don't typically do that. No, I don't like that, but I would add this one for the next one. It's more movement around in here, so I don't usually do it because I haven't practiced it, but. Through those four chords with the walk up and the walk down twice for every, most of the time, except for at the end, and you just go through it. But this was the last third one that I didn't show you, is, or, so just like a regular G chord, except for you're just playing this with the thumb and then with these three fingers, the D, G, and B strings, and third fret on the B string, second fret on the A string, and then back to that C9 thing, which is our C add 9, which is actually a G add 9. So starting from the beginning with that rolled chord. Back to them. And then, so that's the verses and the sort of refrain at the end. Maybe that's more of a refrain, and these are the verses. I think that's more of a refrain, and these are actually the verses. I never really named them. I can't do it very well. I'm also not used to this capo, it's weird. So first, this is a shape where you take, I figured it out by taking that C9 thing and making it minor, and then moving it up to this chord. So it's just like more notes in the E chord, which is 6, 7, 8, 7th fret from the capo, and then 5th fret, so 7th fret on the A string, 5th fret on the 5th fret, like the name of the Scooby-Doo character, that would be funny. 5th fret on the D string, and 7th fret on the B string, and then the rest of them are open. So, it's mostly, it's the thumb pretty much can follow the pattern of just doing root of the chord on 1 and 3 of the waltz, and then on the second beat of each measure, going up a string from wherever it was. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I don't do it on that chord because that brings you up a string, and then I want my fingers to be doing these two strings, so I just 1, 2. That one for the G chord or the C shape with the capo, the C shape, I just have the thumb go on beat 1. Also for this D or this D chord, which is actually a C chord, or sorry, D chord. It is a D chord. No, it's an A chord. But yeah, so the shapes are, which I already taught you, and then which is just a G thing. With this note, obviously, it's important. That third fret on the B string. Which is the same C shape from before. And then this is weird. So 5th fret on the A string, 7th fret on the 7th fret on the D string, open. 7th fret on the B string. Same little thing from the chorus. So that's the other thing, is it? The right hand, it's the offbeat, the third subdivision of the first beat of this, is this finger going, and then the second beat is, you start with it bent up, and then you, because the melody's follow the sign. So the bend follows the follow, doing the same melody. Follow the sign. So that's just a hammer on to the on the A string to the second fret. And then some kind of something to fill the third subdivision of the second beat, which is any of these three strings together or separately. I like, definitely get this one, because I feel like a boom, ba da ba boom, that sounds like a melody you could sing, so it's like a relevant melody. I guess I also like doing that, is where the second beat, you do these two with this finger and this finger. Yeah, that sounds the nicest. I think you should do that. 1, 2, and 1, and then back to, so which is, hammering on each time that you play this. First time is, so it's the first beat is the thumb there, like we talked about. The second beat is, which is those two, these two fingers doing the middle two strings of the guitar. And the first one is hammered on, and then the third beat is 3-2-3, 3-2-3. So the third subdivision of the third beat is this back to open, and they're both played with both of these fingers on the middle two strings. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 3, 2, 3. And then back to. So it does that two times, that. Which is that hammer. And it's nice to play actually on those, on the second beat with that C shape, that C9 shape, play all three of these. I guess you could do it, whatever combination you want. That doesn't sound very good. Yeah, so you're incrementing down, you're decrementing string by string until it's just this one. So you do all three, and then two, and then one. And I always miss that on the way up, especially when I'm just playing it live, but with one guitar, it's a little embarrassing, but whatever. So yeah, it's after that second, you go to this shape. And I guess, the actual melody and the pattern that I had in my head when I was recording it was, which is just first and third subdivisions of each of the three beats in the measure, which is 1, 2, 3. So if you have these three fingers on, so I guess between your thumb and then those three first fingers, you're on the middle four strings of the guitar, just in order. Yeah, so I guess it's thumb, pointer, ring, pointer, middle, thumb, boom, 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 and one more time, it's thumb, pointer, ring, pointer, middle, thumb, and each of those hits on the one, the first and third subdivisions of 1, 2, and 3, so like, I guess, so I should probably start using the one and a kind of thing. One and a two and a three. One and a two and a one, a two, a three. Since we're not putting anything on the ands, so I'm using this classical music theory. I've loved the word kinesthetic recently, but it's not kinesthetic because it's with your voice. Making connections between the, you know, like do, re, mi, solfege stuff. I don't remember what the word for that is, but okay, so here's the verses. Another one, and then to the weird chord. I guess maybe you can put these two together. When you play this one, you put also that fingers on both of these. So this one's hitting on the two and the three. Oh, that's what it was, is you pull off on this, on the last one. So instead of playing that thumb for the and, or the of three, the third subdivision of three, just hammer off on that, or sorry, pull off on that. That'll let you shift to the other chord without. Which is just that similar hammer on thing from the before. 1, 2, 3. Which is just the third beat of that second to last measure is this chord, but then it goes straight back to the G. And I like to use that as a transition, that same thing that we did. Just that sort of D shape, but going back to the repeat. I guess I sometimes accidentally bend That one just a little bit, and it has this nice chorus effect with the E string. But don't do it too much, or else it's... That's weird. To the second one of these fairy lights row. And then after that it goes back to another give me a sign I've been and then at the very end of that one, instead of this is the second time through for the second verse where she give me a sign I've been losing my mind, these ears not too damaged to hear. Save me some time, I've been waiting in line, but I gotta get right out of here. Instead of going like you did for all the other times before, fairy lights round, it's just, save me some time, I've been waiting in line, but I gotta get right. Back to that beginning. You just sort of jam on that, build energy, feel something until it's time to sing. But actually, no, this, yeah, that's the thing. This part, it just loops those chords without doing that. So the last time that you'll do before you've sung that ending refrain part is right after, gotta get right out of here. And then you just go straight to. I quit everything today. When I'm playing it live, I kind of like to give space between those. And then. I can't do anything. And then do it like one or two more times. Everything today, I can do anything. Well, I guess, can do anything. And then I have that melody section. And then it's just the same thing. So that one also starts in a weird place. And it would be after the melody. So you'd probably just loop through it a few times after singing. I quit everything today. I can do anything. So it comes after, it comes after everything today. So instead of going to the, like you would typically after the, you just go. So again, from, let's say that you're singing the last, I quit everything today, I can do anything. I am, you probably wait a little because I think it feels nicer to wait after, you know, so that's died down a little bit, the sort of refrain before you say, I am in so much pain. And then you just loop, find my songs. And you just keep doing that for that last, I don't know, epilogue, not epilogue, what's the word for the coda? So after that coda's done, clearly I trade the process for product. Process for product any day. So that one starts in another different spot, but after process for product. Clearly I trade the process. process for product any day. Wait. Process for product. I mean, that passing chord doesn't really make that much sense. So maybe... maybe just don't play it. Clearly I trade the process for product any day. Any day now. And that's sort of not afterthought necessarily, but that sort of restatement of any day now falls on the second one. And it ends on this very, like, where are we? This very, not, I'm not showing neutral, but like it's fog. That's fog. That's not. Where it's like hope, like something is gonna happen, or it's not. A little bit melancholy and like, this is how things are, and it might be okay. Or, you know, it's not. It's like, it's all right. You know, it's very much the I train the process for product any day. Any day now. And it's not like any day now it's gonna happen. And it's also not like, well, any day, you know, it's not, I'm trying to think of what chord to be. Any day is now, you know, or, any day now, you know, it'll be all right someday soon. It's like, there's something really like, you don't know where any day it could be. Oh, hey, yep. So, sorry, that's the ending, and that's why the ending is the way it is, and that's what I'm happy about, the ending there. But it also sort of implies the process over product, in the sense of, like, you don't know, and things aren't resolved, and that's the reason that that value is so important. Okay, so that's been a long-ass video. Make sure to capo to fret 7 and do everything else. Who's gonna watch a 30? Okay.